So this is one book, it's called Femo, and every week on a Sunday or a Monday I update my blog and I write a blog on it. So these are my stats. So last year I got just under 5,000 views, and this year I've got just under 1,000 views. Last year I've been tagged in Taiwan, and I've been on Adafruit's blog and the Raspberry Pi blog, and my blog has been seen in 62 different countries around the world, which include Taiwan, Nigeria, Puerto Rico, Nepal, and Vietnam. So my site looks like. So this is like the stats. This is my latest blog post, where I went to the event 2016 and I basically show what I've done over the week. It's a lot longer than that. And then the week before that I did wrong. Goes back to about last August. So yeah, there's a lot of blogs on it, and if I could actually get my site. So that's the main page where I write my blogs. Up here I have loads of different bits, so my music, I made a video about Tourette's, I did a bit about coding and physical therapy. I've also done loads of product reviews, so this is one that got put on Adafruit's website because it's actually Adafruit's kit. And then the blog that got put on to the Raspberry Pi website is one about Pi Wars, which I did in December, where me and my mum judged a 3-point turn. In here is what I do in physical computing. This is basically my music reviews. And yeah, this is a film that I made. Yes.
What gave you the idea to make your blog?
The fact that I wanted to show other people what I was doing.
What's the best event you've blogged?
Probably Pi Wars.
You mentioned in the Pi Wars you something about you were judging a 3-point turn.
Yes.
Can you just tell us a bit about that?
So the 3-point turn, the robot basically goes forwards, turns left, reverses back, and then goes back down the same line it came back up. And so we judged it so that it, so the idea was it didn't go out the lines, and at least one wheel finished in the starting blocks.
What advice would you give to people who wanted to set up their own blog?
Think of your ideas, don't spend money quickly. Make sure you choose a template that's good, because you can't change the template. And make sure you do have something to blog about. Andy?
What's the top five best products you've had to blog, or you want to blog about?
That's a hard question. Well, the top five products would probably have to be, firstly, the Crumblebot. Then the Kano, the Raspberry Pi tablet touchscreen, and the Tech Will Save Us Thirsty Plant Kit. Yes.
What have you got planned for this year, computing wise, log wise?
Well, it'll probably be the same as last year, but there'll probably be more stuff because I only started this in August last year.
Are you going to be judging again at any competitions?
Hopefully Pi Wars again.
Good.
Are you going to enter Pi Wars with your own robot?
Definitely.
You can't judge then?
No. I can get my mum to judge.
Brilliant.
Hey, Femi, one more question. What was the first thing you ever did with a Raspberry Pi when you first got it? Well, firstly, I didn't know how to use it. First thing I probably ever did was play in Scratch. Uh-huh. And made the Scratch person move. That's about the first thing I did.
That's good.
Yep.
Just a little bit of an ad. We've got Chelmsford Raspberry Jam in 2 weeks' time. Do you want to tell us what you've got planned? Because Femi's actually running a workshop in Chelmsford.
So for the Chelmsford Raspberry Jam, I'm running a robot workshop where we're going to be making the CamJam robot kits. So we're going to use the boxes as chassis. We're going to have all the bits and pieces and a whole load of screwdrivers. And we're going to make the robots move using the Kano keyboards. Yes.
Are these CamJam robot kits, do people have to buy them if they want to make a robot? Are they going to be supplied? And can they take them away at the end of the day?
So they can't really take them away at the end of the day. I think if they have done like almost the whole thing, we might let them take it home.
Okay.
So they can continue it at home. I think it usually cost £20, I think. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yes, Andy.
Tell us about your code club and how you set it up and how you got money for it.
So I did a crowdfunding campaign on Indiegogo where I raised £1,230. And about half of that was from OSPA, who gave me £500 towards it. And we spent that on a whole load of electrical appliances that we could use for the Raspberry Pi. And we also spent that on Code Club resources. And so I did a 6-week Code Club where we invited a whole load of people who wanted to do some coding who came to our first jam. And they came and did Kano, Sonic Pi, and Python. Yes.
What did you use to make your site?
I use WordPress.
The co-club that you set up, was there a reason that you set that up?
I set it up because I wanted people in the local area to be able to do coding for free. Yes, Andy.
Where else have you done talks?
I did a talk in Cambridge, I think, and that was the first thing that I reviewed. And I've done talks in a lot of other places.